Welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to make some candle holders with these mason jars. I was inspired by this post on Pinterest. And yeah, I have some foil here, some glue. I mean, this is a stick right now, but I'm going to dissolve it. And for one of them I will probably make some bottle of it rather than a candle, and for that I have these acrylic paints. For those I have these, and I was also inspired by this mason jar that I made in kindergarten, which I always found was kind of cute but still imperfect. So yeah, that's the story behind that. So hope you have fun watching. I think we get started with the pumpkin one. And for this, I'm just going to wrap this around the jar first to see where I should cut it. So take off the lid because we don't need this if it is going to be a candle. And I wonder where exactly I should let this jar end. I just went around it and yeah, hope you can see that right in there. There is the line I marked. Cute. First I'm going to wrap it around the other way. Which is kind of worse, but then I'm drawing on a pumpkin face, like right at the middle here, I guess. So now I need my knife. I have this beautiful knife that I inherited by my grandfather, and that is very sharp, so it's great to cut this out. So now I need to know where this will be going. Mark it from the inside, it's better. Wait. Didn't want that close to it. Okay. You can see where I marked it. There and there. The first pencil. I think I will also need the height. Somewhere down there, somewhere up here. Cut that out. Let that dry a little bit. Now you will need a lot of glue to get this to stick. I don't really know how much I need. But let's just start, right? For the next one, we probably need to clean this one up. I got myself this blue sky paper. Cutting it off right there, because I want to get it up here, and that works better if I do that this way. So from the start, layer down some of the glue. Maybe this is even too long. So we cut off what's left over. For this lamp, we need to cut out some witches. This is all right, I think. Probably works out doing it on there. Perfect. Still sticky. Maybe this witch is a bit too big. Oops. There's still a lot of space. I think I will cut out some bats, maybe, and a cat, for example. Just doing bets because they're easy.
Cute kitty.
You know what this cat maybe needs? A chimney to sit on. Chimney for the cat. How high must it be? Thank you.
This is so fucking cute.
Maybe we should put the moon over here.
All right, we got this white color. And then I'll mix a bit gold in there to give it some shimmer. One last bit we need. A big bat.
Right here. Where do I want to put it? Here. This will work now.
Right.
Nice. So, now for the one that is not going to be like the others. Oh, if I can open the jar, that is. Yeah, first of all, let's start with this one. Alright, I think that's opaque now.
Fuck it up.
Okay.
So this is the last thing. We have to let that dry now before we can put on the other color.
This is now dried, as you can see. It's the same day. And now I'm going to paint the label. Thank you. So this is it. These are my three lanterns, the one I made in kindergarten and the ones that I made now. I have this one with the cat and the witch and the little bats on it. And this pumpkin lantern. And this jar, which now contains my earrings. Well, the smaller ones that you tend to lose. Yeah, I hope you like this video. I will give you some close-up shots of them right now in darkness. I think that will be a bit nicer for the lanterns. I mean, you've got some close-up shots of the earring jar already, but not from the others yet. Subscribe to my channel for more stuff like this. Have a nice day. Thanks for watching. Follow my social media, don't forget that. Bye.